step one, choose a topic. The next step, we're now up to stage three. Final step will be the submission. Stage three, doing the project. I don't simply want you to grab a camera and start filming. I don't want you to, or taking photos or recording. Part of the major project is the folio. I want you to practice collecting information about what you're doing right from the beginning, right from this project. So I want you to make sure that you have notes, so that you have things to do in the folio. Even in a coronavirus world, you can still do a really good folio. In fact, it's probably going to be more critical that your folio really reflect understanding where your outcomes may have been compromised because of social distancing. So what goes into your folio? Research. First thing is research. Now research is working out how you're going to do it, but it's also finding examples of what it might look like and how other people have done similar types of work. For instance, photography. If you're doing photography, then what I want you to do is to find photographers online who are doing work which is similar to the sort of look that you want to achieve. And collect their images, put those into your folio, put in notes about why you chose them, why you like them, what it is about their work that you want to try and replicate. You might find that there might be a number of different photographic artists that you want to try and mimic. So you're taking aspects of this photographer and aspects of this photographer and putting them together in the work that you want to do. You might, for instance, this is just random, but you might want to do portraiture, but you also want to do landscape, sort of outdoor sort of look. And so your task is that you're going to get use ideas of portrait photography and also the ideas of how to get a good landscape image. If you were doing a video, a film, then I want you to actually pick a couple of filmmakers, study their work, and in particular look at their direction style, their filming style, particularly think about the camels. How do they use lighting? What the hell? Oh, we've now got three kangaroos out there. How do they use the camels? How do they use lighting? How do they use audio? Look at the acting styles. It's particularly useful if you're doing a short film of some sort that you have videos, clips that show the acting, that you can show the actors how you want them to act. One of the things that you'll often find with amateur actors and untrained or inexperienced actors is that they will overact. So it's probably a good idea to have some videos of what you consider good acting, the style of acting that you want, so that they can sort of mimic that, and also so that you've got a better idea in your head of what it should look like when they're acting well. Another thing that really focus on is framing, how they're actually filming it. You can see the way that I filmed this. I've got the frame just above my head, it's going down to my knees. It's not a really good shot, but then, you know, I'm showing off the background as much as anything. Now there's four kangaroos out there. Animation. Find some animators that you like. With all of these things, it's all about having evidence, putting that so that you can put it into your folio. Not just showing them, don't just grab images and go plonk, 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 plonk in the folio. Make sure that you are annotating those, that you are putting in comments saying why you chose them, what is it that you like about them, what do you understand about what they're doing that you want to integrate into the work that you're going to be doing. Folio also, if you're choosing to do a really technical thing and you go to use YouTube or Google to find tutorials, then I want you to make a note of each place that you find information and even take some screen captures, cut and paste some notes from websites. Say if you were doing something with filmmaking, it might be information about editing. If you were doing photography, it might be, oh, there's a kangaroo just bouncing past behind the camera there. Hello guys, hello my love. It's Jill. Jill's one of our regular visitors here. Hello sweetie, she's been coming here since she was a baby. Hello, how are you darling? Yeah, you can come here. No, just eat the grass, that's fine. I'm doing a good job of mowing that down. Hello darling. Sorry, a bit distracting. Yeah, collect technical information. Your book should read like an instruction book, or your folio for this section could be something of an instruction book. If you were to give it to somebody else, then they would have the same tutorial learning and knowledge that you've currently got. And even including links to really useful website pages. So you've got all of those resources put together.